Today, here we are going to discuss the introduction of XML, that is called as an extensible markup language of Internet Programming subject from unit number 3. Now, what is the XML or what do you mean by XML? XML stands for Extensible Markup Language, a markup language which is used to provide the informations about documents. The tags are added to the document to provide the extra informations. HTML tags tell the browsers how to display the documents, but the XML tags gives the reader some idea about what the data means, actually what data contain in it. That is very important related to XML. Now, what is the XML or what is the use of XML? XML documents are used to transfer the data from one place to another place over the internet. We know that when we use the HTML, HTML is used to create a page, whereas the XML is used to transfer the data from one place to another place, where we can say that it is a one type of database. We can create it with the help of XML. Now, XML is a subset are designed to particular applications. What it indicate? XML is a subset are designed for particular applications. Now, it is used to send the breaking news bulletins from one site to another. A number of fields have their own subset. These include chemistry, mathematics, book publishing. The most of these subsets are registered with the W3 consortium and available anyone to use. Now, what are the advantages of XML? The XML is a text Unicode base. Take up less space. It can be transmitted efficiently. If you send the data from one place to another, it is transmitted very efficiently. When XML documents can be displayed different media, HTML, video, CD, DVD. Only have changes the XML document in order to change all the rest. XML document can be modularized and part can be used. What I say, XML document can be modularized and it can be reused. What is the basics example of HTML? How we create a HTML page? Afterward, we are going to see the how we create a or how we do the XML. If we see the example of HTML documents, here we need the HTML. That means what are the, it has basic structures, HTML, body sections, body section close and HTML section close. HTML contain the head sections, head again contain the title sections, title contain the close the title and head section again we need to close it. Now what happened in the body sections? Body section indicate the actually the content we want to display. What it indicate in body sections? The body sections shows the content we want to display. Here we have want to display the two elements, that is called this is an example of page and some information goes in here. Here we provide the heading tags and with that we have closed the body tag. So it is a basic example of HTML where we can declare the HTML or we can show the HTML page. Now we are going to see how we create a XML documents. Here XML has its versions, that is called as 1.0. It has the specific syntax, XML versions, standalone systems, XML version, what version, and standalone systems. Here we have declared the XML and version 1.0. Then here we have the root node. So it is called as a root node. What are the attribute or what are the different tags here? We must include all the tags in the root tags. So here we identify address is a one root and here we have closed that address. If we have the address informations, Alizely, Ali, phone number and birth date. What three informations here we have related to address? Name, email, phone number and birth. Fourth actually informations here we have. So all the four informations must be contained in the root tags. And basic things with the XML, we can create the own tags. Here is address is a user defined tags. Here name is again user defined tags. So all the tags we can create with the XML is a user defined tags. XML is used to transport the data, whereas the HTML is used to create a page. That is a very or basics important difference between the XML and HTML. Now, difference between the HTML and XML. HTML tags have fixed meaning and browser known that it is. XML tags are different for different application and user know what they means. HTML tags are used for display. HTML tags are used for the display. XML tags are used to describe the documents and data. That is most important difference. HTML tags are used to display the data, and the second, the XML tags are used to describe the documents and data. What are the documents and data here we have? Now, XML rows. There are the enclosed in the angle bracket. What are the tags in the XML? It must be enclosed in the angle brackets. Now, the tags come in the pair with the start tag and the end tags. What are the tags here we need? It must have in the pair tag. Here we observe the name, and the tag must be properly nested. What are the tag here we have? The tag must be properly named. The tag that do not have the end tag must be terminated by a. Here you can observe. Now, XML rules. The tags are case sensitive. What are the tags we are going to provide in the XML? That is called as a user defined tag. It is a XML. We cannot write here as given in example, where we write the A is small in letter in the first tag, and where in the second we are writing an uppercase letter. It is not allowed. It is not permissible in XML. The tags follow the Java naming conventional, except that single column character allowed. They must begin with the letter and they do not whiteface. Document must have the single root tag begin with the documents. Already I have discussed that while creating the XML document, it must have contained in the root sections. That is called as a document must have single root tag that begin with the documents. XML encoding. XML uses Unicode to encode the character. Unicode comes in many flavors. The most common use Unicode is UTF-8. Now, thank you for